the venous blood sample into a sequestrated bottle, mix very well, and take a drop onto a microscope slide. You can also as well take a finger prick from the third or ring finger. Using a microscope slide as a spreader, spread the blood drop of blood into a thin film. Air dry the smear, the blood smear, on a draining rack. Prepare a thick smear by putting blood from a sequestrated bottle onto the microscope slide, or as well you can use a finger prick, blood from a finger prick. Using a microscope slide, spread the blood out. Allow it to air dry on the draining rack or in an incubator. Stain the thick smear in a filled stain A for 5 seconds, and this dehomoglobinizes the red blood cells. Wash under the tap water or buffered water. Put it in full stain B for 5 seconds, after which you wash under the tap water or with buffered water. Air dry it on the draining rack. Fix the thin smear in methanol for 2 seconds. Allow it to air dry and put it in full stain B for 6 seconds. After which you wash under the tap water or buffered water. Put it in full stain A for 6 seconds. After which you wash under the tap water to get rid of the excess stain. And this stain is called reverse staining, and this preserves the red blood cells. Stain the thick smear in 1 in 10 dilution of Giemsa for 5 to 15 minutes. Wash the excess stain under tap water or buffered water. The thin smear is fixed in methanol for 2 seconds, after which it is put in the Giemsa 1 in 10 dilution for 5 to 15 minutes. Wash off the excess stain under tap water or using buffered water, and air dry it on draining rack. Examine the stain slide under times 100 using oil immersion. Yeah, expected to see for the thick film the parasite and the white blood cells. The parasite will look like a ring form or dots which appear in pairs. But in a thin form, the parasites are found inside the red blood cell, for which we can use it to determine the species of the parasites.